Hey, what's up guys, Ken here. Have you ever heard of the branded and more expensive product gives you the better quality and performance? Is it true? Let's find out.
How did you do that?
Hi again. Before I start this video, I should say the result in this video is based on my test bench result. Basically, this is all of my personal experiment result. So I have no offense to the product, to every product companies. I just want to prove that along with my curiosity. Yes, something happened that made me want to prove that. So I've got three thermal compounds here. The HY510, the K4-Pro and K5-Pro. Before this video, I've posted the entire procedure and detailed information on my Twitter, Google+, and blog. You have already know that if you're following me. So without further ado, let's compare the price, shall we? So, this is a screenshot from ebay.com. HY510 is $1 per piece. This is K-series product. This is combo one, so it came with K4 and K5 in a package. It is $8, basically $4 each. So what do you think? Which one do you think is the best? Or maybe let's roll the product information. Then you will be quite sure which one will be the best among these three thermal compounds. When I first get into this website, computersystem.gr, I found that they claim their products feature 3 times higher thermal conductivity than the normal thermal plates and pads. That's the reason why I bought them. I'll let you know later. The thermal conductivity of K5 has more than 5.3 volt per meter Kelvin, while the K4 has more than 4.6 volt per meter Kelvin. Both are no electrical conductivity as they stated. And the viscosity of K5 is higher than the K4 because it is designed to replace thermal pads on common memory chips on the video cards. The K4 is adversely used on CPU and GPU. Okay, now, this is the information from ebay.com. HY510 features high-grade stability, can be applied to CPU, VGA and chipset as well. Low thermal resistance. The thermal conductivity is more than 1.93 volt per meter Kelvin, 3 times lower than the K4 Pro.
No dumb, right? Quite simple. The K-series product is completely standout, obviously. But there are just the website information to tell you about. But what is actually happened on my test bench and my other PC?
Alright, so this is the test bench information I should give you for better reference. The CPU that I'm using is 2140, 1.6 GHz. I'm using a stock heatsink, so I mod screw mount method already. The motherboard is Gigabyte G31MS2L. Memory 1GB 667 MHz. No PCIe and no PCI in use. Super basic, huh? I started the testing at room temperature around 28 to 29 degrees Celsius with very good airflow condition during the summer night. Stress test the CPU by using heavy load application to run about 10 minutes for each test. First, without unscrew anything on my test bench, the current thermal paste at that time was HY510, so I ran heavy load at the first time and did my first test of HY510. The CPU maximum temperature is 63 degrees Celsius. And then I unscrew the CPU, he's saying, had a look at the CPU and his interface. The paste was spread out very well covered, greasy and easy to remove thanks to its silicone base. I cleaned up everything by using polylab contents alcohol 95%. Afterwards, I repeat the same test for every single thermal compound. I repeat the same procedure 3 times like a robot. And eventually, the result came out. is surprisingly disappointed. Finally, I ended up with all the disappointment. I spent my money, I spent my time for doing all this, it just because something happened. I bought a more expensive product, I thought it would be some temperature drops or something, but it's not. I heated the test bench and see what happened. Now as you can see, the test bench result is totally contrary of our expectation, like we mentioned earlier. I'm not willing to say, but I never expect the HY510 will be the best. K5-Pro 75 degrees Celsius, K4-Pro 69 degrees Celsius, and the HY510 is 63 degrees Celsius. These are the CPU maximum temperature after I using the stress test application for running about 10 minutes each. Last week, after I tested the HY510 and I found that it is no electrical conductivity, then I tried it on my laptop since it is getting hot while gaming. So guess what? Temperature dropped at least 5 degrees Celsius, which means it works well for laptop too. Full service is recommended once a year, so the durability is not taken into account or a test.
Alright, so to be clear, I would like to say I'm not supposed to tell you which one is best to buy, which one is not to buy. I'm not. This is just a comparison video, so hope you understand. I'm just going to share what happened on me, my experience happened in the past few weeks. That's all about it. So if you find this video helpful, make sure you like, share and subscribe. If you have anything to say, feel free to comment down the comment box below. And I like learning. So thank you for watching.